ka bang mag-bake, tapos yung in-slice mo yung cake mo, nakita mo madaming mga tiny air pockets up to large air bubbles or yung tunneling. So, here are the reason bakit nagkakaroon ng large uneven bubbles dun sa cake batter natin. So, first is gluten formation. So, naalala nyo kapag magbe-bake tayo ng breads, tapos kailangan natin siyang inid ng 10 to 15 minutes para ma-form yung gluten, para pag binake natin, merong mga large air pockets. So that's gluten formation. We don't need that sa ating cake. So dapat, less mixing lang yung ginagawa natin sa ating cake batter. Second, madami yung chemical leavener na nilagay mo, or hindi evenly na disperse yung chemical leavener. So that's why sa ibang culinary school, ina-advise na strain or salain yung harina together with dry ingredients and chemical leaveners such as baking soda and baking powder 2 to 3 times para even yung pagkakadistribute, para walang section or segment na mas madami yung baking powder or baking soda. Third, proper temperature. Yung ibang recipe, they require room temperature ng milk, water, and eggs para mahalo sila or magawa yung tinatawag na emulsion process. Tandaan nyo, pag isa sa mga liquid ingredients nyo or wet ingredients nyo ay mas malamig, hindi magkakaroon ng proper emulsion. So, follow the recipe and as much as possible, dapat proper yung temperature ng mga ingredients. Pag sinabing room temp, dapat nasa room temp. Number 4, yung way nyo ng paglalagay ng cake batter sa mga cake pans. Kung maaalala nyo yung karamihan sa mga nagbe-bake na napapanood nyo, ang ginagawa nila is tinatap nila dun sa counter table or sa mga tabletop yung cake pans once nalagay na yung cake batter. This is to push out the air bubbles or the large air pockets na nahalo or nagkaroon or na-develop during the process ng mixing at yung pagpo-pour nyo ng cake batter sa cake pans. So, kailangan itatap natin ng 2 to 3 times yung ating cake pans bago isa lang sa oven. So, number 5 is over-whipping the wet ingredients, especially the eggs. As you all know, kapag wini-whip natin yung eggs, nag-i-incorporate doon yung mga air pockets sa egg whites. So, make sure do not over-whip the eggs. As well as dun sa egg yolk. Kasi, natatrap din dun yung mga tiny air bubbles kapag in-over-whip na natin siya. So, possible reason yung over-mixing ng eggs. And then number, use the appropriate cake flour. Again, when you're using all-purpose flour, it has more gluten than cake flour. So, one way para maiwasan yung mga large air pockets or lots of tiny bubbles is to use cake flour para hindi sensitive sa over-mixing or over-whipping. So, again, number one, do not over-mix your cake batter to prevent the gluten formation. Number two, make sure that the chemical leavener is properly distributed or dispersed to your cake flour. Number 3, proper and dry temperature. Number 4, tap or bang the cake pans to your counter table to push out the air bubbles. Number 5, do not over whip or over mix the eggs. And number 6, use the right type of flour. Yun lang.